Gospels are those stories, narrative, Jesus teaching us about the Father, about himself, about us, the church, life, death, everything in between. That's what a parable is. So today we focus on the parable of the sheep and the goats. So this teaches us multiple things, really. First, it's end times. Eschatological. Eschatology, the study of the last days, the last things. So on the last day, you have the separation of the sheep and the goats. Now, this is important to remember when Jesus is telling this story. He first separates them. These are the sheep. These are the goats. And then he talks about their life. Not the other way around. So first, we are reckoned sheep, declared goats. This is who we are, and who we are determines what we do. So the sheep are the ones that then visit the sick, take care of the stranger, feed the hungry, give the thirsty water. Whatever you do to the least of these, my brethren, you did unto me, says Jesus to the sheep. Then to the goats, he says, you didn't do these things. You didn't come visit. You didn't let in. You didn't give food. You didn't give drink. And whatever you did to the least of these, you did not do to me. So when Jesus teaches this, he's not just teaching us about the last judgment. He's teaching us about what the Christian life looks like. That's really the point of this parable, is what does the baptismal life look like? The baptismal life is sacrificial living for your neighbor. Because we are sheep, because we are declared righteous, we are created anew, given a new wardrobe, you know? It's like when you go to Target, you feel bougie and fancy on the way out and live differently. In Christ, you now have a fancy life. You do things for your neighbor, loving them unconditionally as Jesus does you. But a goat, there's no conversion there. There's no new life there, so we don't live this way. So even our good works can be for our comfort because we know it's not coming from us. We don't even see them. Jesus sees them. We don't. But we know that Christ has done these things for us, and now he continues to live through us. So when we read the parable of the sheep and the goats, let us take heart that we don't go to heaven because we've done enough good works to get there. We are welcomed unto the eternal dwellings because we have been declared sheep, declared followers of Christ, declared righteous in his blood. And we just happen to live good lives here because of Jesus. That's not why we're going, just how we occupy our time while here below. So God bless y'all, and I pray that's been helpful. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Thanks for watching Higher Things video shorts. Remember to like, subscribe for notifications, and donate to support Higher Things at higherthings.org/giving. If you like this video, check out our website, higherthings.org, and check out more content from Higher Things.